Hello, I'm Dr. Norbert Gleich, and I'm the medical director and chief scientist here at the Center for Human Reproduction in New York. I want today to talk a little bit about the androgen patch, because it seems that there's a lot of chatting going on surrounding utilization of this patch in various infertility situations. So, just by way of background, the androgen patch is a skin patch that delivers the hormone testosterone to whoever puts this kind of a patch on. This is a very efficient delivery system, and therefore patch deliveries have become popular for various hormones. Now, this patch was not developed for women. It was initially developed for men who have much higher testosterone levels than women, and where supplementation has remained a pretty controversial issue. But it is a widely used practice, and a lot of men, particularly at advanced ages, for a whole variety of reasons, supplement their testosterone levels, and the patch is a very, very good way of doing that. But remember that men have about 10 times the testosterone levels of women, and therefore women have to be very, very careful in using various patches. There are obviously patches that deliver different quantities, but what is important to remember is that only 15 years ago, androgens, and particularly the most active androgen, male hormone, testosterone, was kind of viewed as being toxic in women. And there's a good reason for that, because too high levels of androgens do all kinds of bad things to ovaries. We know that from patients with so-called PCOS, polycystic ovary syndrome, who very frequently have excessively high androgen levels. So based on that very frequent condition, until about 15 years ago, it was very widely believed that androgens, and specifically testosterone, are really bad for women who are trying to get pregnant. We then learned that, like so many times in nature, it is not an all or nothing issue. In other words, androgens are not per se bad for women. Indeed, if they were, they probably wouldn't be there. The simple fact that evolution has maintained androgen levels in women and female hormone levels in men obviously means that there must be a meaning to that. And the truth is that both too little and too much is bad. In other words, like most hormones, androgens work within a certain therapeutic range, and that range is obviously different in men and in women. And that's why coming to the androgen patch, it is very important to understand what testosterone delivery does and why we here at CHR, even when we do supplement women who have low androgen levels and when we do try to raise their testosterone levels, we usually don't do it by giving them testosterone, either as a gel or through a patch. We instead prefer to give them DHEA, dehydroepiandrosterone. And the reason is simple. This is how our bodies make testosterone. Our bodies make testosterone from DHEA. And if we give to a patient DHEA, the precursor of testosterone, rather than testosterone itself, every organ in the body will just take as much substrate, as much precursor out of circulation as it needs to make its best testosterone levels, which means different organs have different testosterone levels. Ovaries require different testosterone than, for example, the liver. And therefore, if you give testosterone, you're flooding the woman's complete body, and it is quite easy to get into toxic level. If you give DHEA, every organ, the ovaries included, take only as much as they need to make adequate testosterone levels, and therefore it's almost impossible to get into toxic levels. That's why we here at CHR use testosterone, whether by gel or patch, only in a very small number of women who do not convert well DHEA to testosterone. But as I said, that is only a very small number of women. And for most women, we feel DHEA is a much better way to supplement. Thanks for listening.